if we take a look here at this chart, this gives us a majority of the metric prefix that you're responsible for. Now, there's some that go after Pico, and there are some that go after Terra. But for the most part, professors will stick to this core group of metric prefixes. And what we're going to have to say here is, just remember, this is very important. One is associated with the metric prefix. So one is associated with each one of these metric prefixes. What does that mean? So let's say I had a picometer. So meter is a base. Pico is the metric prefix that goes in front of it. Since one is associated with my metric prefix, we're going to say one picometer is equal to, see right here, 10 to the negative 12 meters. It's a way of setting things up where you form a relationship between the metric prefix and the base. Let's say I had kilo. Okay. So let's say I had kilograms and I wanted to go to grams. So we'd say that for every one, because kilo is a metric prefix, for every 1 kilogram, it is 10 to the 3 grams. So that's what I mean by one is associated with the metric prefix. So remember that when we're doing these types of metric prefix conversions.